extraordinary.
I mean, is your understanding of mathematics also suggestive of a divine artificer?
No, it has to do with my experience.
Your ability to learn language?
Do you understand? It has to do with my experience of you. When I'm looking at you right now,
right. Mm-hmm.
You may assume that what I see is immaterial, but that's not what I see. And it's not what I believe. And I think
I understand it's not what you
there's
believe.
There's something in you that is more than you believe. I really think so.
This is
now. If you want to make that a scientific claim, you can. But I'm telling you, it's a metaphysical claim, and to confuse the two is a mistake.
Okay. You can add any metaphysics you want.
Thank you.
By that means, I mean I can say I see you as a reincarnate personality, and I think you were probably
I was someone famous
on Atlantis. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Right. Don't make me like a washerwoman in a previous
people. People do this all the time. I mean, you can broadcast. I mean, this is constrained by our common sense in every other domain of discourse. I mean, just take, for example, the people who think Elvis is still alive. Okay. What's wrong with this claim? I mean, why is this claim not vitiating our academic departments and corporations? Mm-hmm. I mean, I'll tell you why, and it's very simple. We have not passed laws against believing Elvis is still alive. The problem is that whenever somebody seriously represents his belief that Elvis is still alive, in a conversation, on a first date, at a lecture, at a job interview, he immediately pays a price.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
He pays a price in ill-concealed laughter.
Right. Now, surely you can agree with
that. That is a good thing. Then he could rattle on about this is not a scientific claim. This is a matter of faith. You know, when I look at you, I see you might be Elvis. I mean, he could do this.
Except that.
Yeah.